plants have been the driving force of evolution on our planet ever since life first emerged 3.5 billion years ago. Many major evolutionary innovations depended on new inventions by plants. To view some of these breakthroughs, we'll visit now the Plant Evolution Garden at the Edmund J. Safra campus of the Hebrew University of Jerusalem. The first and most important invention of plants, a rather of photosynthetic bacteria, was photosynthesis. In photosynthesis, plants use solar energy to break down water and fix carbon dioxide to make sugar and release oxygen. Photosynthesis has thus two major aspects. The first is that it uses solar energy to generate sugar, a chemical almost all organisms use as a direct or indirect source of energy. The second aspect is the release of oxygen. Up to the invention of photosynthesis, the atmosphere contained no oxygen. Oxygen makes up now 20% of the atmosphere and is used for breathing by all multicellular organisms. Plants started to colonize land about 500 million years ago. Moving to the hostile and dry land required significant adaptations and the development of structures and strategies, including those for reproduction. Plants did extremely well on land. If the typical plant in water was a short-lived, single-celled algae, the typical land plant is a huge tree that lives for many years. Plant colonization of land enabled animals to follow suit and to start living on land as well. The first group of terrestrial plants, often called Flora 1, consisted of mosses, horsetails, and ferns. All of these are represented here. Mosses are tiny, but the ferns you see here have already roots, stems, and leaves, and can grow very big. They used to form huge forests, which fed herbivorous dinosaurs. Much of what we burn today as fossil fuel was once plants of this Flora 1. Ferns do not form seeds, but have spores. We'll discuss spores and the remarkable sex life of early land plants in the next video. The next step, called Flora 2, was the evolution of plants that make real seeds. Seeds are an amazing invention as they enable plants to send their offspring far away into space and time. The first seeds were made by plants that didn't have flowers and are called gymnosperms, naked seeds. This ginkgo here is one of their earliest representatives and is considered a living fossil. We'll know only in 2025 whether this tree will make seeds or whether it is a male. The Cycas trees here are other representatives of this group. A very important group of gymnosperms are conifers. There are not that many species of them around today, but they cover huge areas in North America, Europe, and Asia, where you can travel for days without seeing anything but conifers. They also hold some records. The oldest organisms on Earth are the bristlecone pines that can reach an age of 5,000 years. The biggest organisms on our planet are the redwoods, some of which stand more than 100 meters tall. Here we can see a slice of such a huge redwood and also a living one, much smaller as it doesn't seem to like growing so far from its native California. However, all these plants didn't make flowers and depend on wind pollination. The big change happened about 200 million years ago when the first flowering plants appeared. Their success was phenomenal, and there are well over 300,000 different species of them around today. One of the most special aspects of flowering plants is their coevolution with animals required for pollination and seed dispersal. We'll discuss these issues in several videos in this chapter.